We have Freddie Highmore, Charlie Bucket. Freddie Highmore was thrust into the spotlight after first appearing in Finding Neverland, then starring as Charlie Bucket in 2005. Around the time of Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, Freddie Highmore was in a ton of kid-oriented films including Finding Neverland, Arthur and the Invisibles, and The Spiderwick Chronicles. He gave his voice to several video games and animated adventures before finding his feet in the industry. Highmore played one of cinema's best-known characters, Norman Bates, in the TV horror mystery Bates Motel from 2013 to 2017. He has starred as Norman Bates in a decidedly un-kiddie project, the Psycho prequel television series Bates Motel. The 24-year-old is returning to the role again for the fifth and final season in 2017, and has graduated to writing for the show too. Most recently, Highmore has been starring in The Good Doctor as Dr. Sean Murphy. The star is believed to live in London and chooses to avoid social media where possible. Jordan Fry, Mike TV. Charlie in the Chocolate Factory was one of the first acting roles Jordan Fry ever got. Just 2 years after playing Mike TV, Fry was one of the voices in the animated adventure Meet the Robinsons. His next significant role would come in 2012. Jordan Fry has appeared in a few scattered projects since The Chocolate Factory, most recently showing up in the Amanda Seyfried starring thriller Gone in 2012. Unlike his monstrous little character, Instagram informs us that Fry managed to tear himself away from his TV recently for a few backpacking trips around the world. After taking a break from acting for a while, Fry has two upcoming roles to look forward to. He's going to be appearing in the rom-com Bird and the Bees in the near future. Philip Weigratz, Augustus Gloop. Being cast as Augustus Gloop was Philip Weigratz's very first acting role. The German actor used that exposure to launch an acting career, but by 2013, his time in the spotlight came to an end. Weigratz appeared in the historical drama Lore in 2012 and the 2013 German fantasy Ruby Red. During the filming of Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, Weigratz wore a bodysuit, which meant he didn't have to gain weight for the role of Augustus Gloop. After nearly drowning in that river of chocolate, Philip Weigratz has focused on acting in his native Germany. He was featured in the Wild Chick series, as well as Lore and Rubenrot, but hasn't been seen since 2013 mockumentary Mein Sommer 88. Julie Winter, Veruca Salt. Julia Winter, Veruca Salt. Julia Winter was perfect for the role of Veruca Salt, and she made us all really want to see her meet a horrible end. Although she was outstanding in the only acting role, we hear that she's pursuing a medical career in Sweden these days, or maybe the squirrels just never gave her back. Helena Bonham Carter, Mrs. Bucket. Since starring in Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, Helena Bonham Carter has continued to be one of the biggest stars in the world. She was cast as Bellatrix Lestrange in the Harry Potter series and the Red Queen in Alice in Wonderland. The big roles kept on coming for Bonham Carter, and in 2011, she was nominated for an Oscar for her performance in the biographical drama The King's Speech. By now, Bonham Carter had established herself as a big star, and she continued to feature in major Hollywood productions such as Cinderella and Les Miserables. Most recently, Bonham Carter has been cast as Princess Margaret in the Netflix drama The Crown, which dramatizes the life of Queen Elizabeth II. Johnny Depp, Willy Wonka. Johnny Depp was the only man that Tim Burton considered for the role, and the actor seemingly didn't think twice about taking the role. Before starring in Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, Depp was already a huge star thanks to his roles in films like Edward Scissorhands and Pirates of the Caribbean. Depp starred alongside Bonham Carter in the Alice in Wonderland remake as the Mad Hatter. The star has followed in Bonham Carter's footsteps and has become part of the Harry Potter universe after being cast as Grindelwald in the Fantastic Beasts movies. Depp has had an up and down time of things in his personal life after a failed marriage to actress Amber Heard ended in divorce in 2017. Francesca Tronger, Mrs. Gloop. German actress Francesca Tronger has been in the movie industry for a very long time, but she hasn't really been featured in many Hollywood productions. Instead, she has become a staple of German cinema, and Tronger very rarely found herself starring in American productions. The main thing that Tronger is known for in Germany is her long-standing role in the medical romance drama The Country Doctor, which she starred in from 2001 to 2013. Her most recent role was as a minor character in the family show Circle of Life. Most of her roles were in German TV movies and series. In 2009, Tronger published her autobiography, Für Schubach zu dick, Too Fat to be Typecast. Starting in 1976, Tronger was part of the theater company Berliner Ensemble. She dubbed minor roles in several Miss Marple TV series, example, A Murder is Announced and A Pocket Full of Rye. Shelley Kahn, Princess Pondicherry. British actress Shelley Kahn got her big break thanks to Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. Before starring as Princess Pondicherry, Kahn had a few minor roles on British television, but afterwards she appeared more regularly on TV. Khan starred in TV series such as The Innocence Project, Raw, Mistress, and Heartbeat. The actress was chosen by Steven Spielberg to star in the ill-fated TV series Terra Nova in 2011. Her most recent role came in the 2019 Fox drama series Deep State, where she had a recurring role as Nicole Miller. Missy Pyle, Mrs. Beauregard. Missy Pyle got her start in the acting business several years before starring in Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. Her first notable role was in Galaxy Quest in 1999, and since then she has appeared in over 170 different films or TV shows. She has appeared in a number of successful films including Big Fish and Bringing Down the House, both in 2013, 50 First Dates, and Dodgeball, A True Underdog Story, both in 2004, Just My Luck in 2006, Gone Girl in 2014, and Captain Fantastic in 2016. Pyle has appeared in both TV and film during her career, but earned critics' praise for her roles in the films The Artist and Captain Fantastic. Her most recent role was as Mercedes in a 2019 horror film, Ma. Deep Roy, Oompa Loompas. Deep Roy had been in the film industry for many years, but this role was his first real exposure to life in Hollywood. He has performed many other roles in movies and on television. Since appearing as the Oompa Loompas, Roy earned roles in Star Trek, Transformers, Revenge of the Fallen, and Paranormal Movie. Roy played Keenzer in the Star Trek reboot and followed up that appearance in the sequels, Star Trek Into the Darkness and Star Trek Beyond. His last major role was in Star Trek Beyond, which released in 2016. One of his more prominent speaking roles, Roy played Aaron, a violent Mumbai-born Mexican criminal, in the second season of the HBO comedy Eastbound and Down. Anna Sophia Robb, Violet Beauregard. Anna Sophia Robb really shot to fame after appearing as Violet Beauregard in Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. Shortly after her Chocolate Factory appearance, Anna Sophia Robb starred in the devastating Bridge to Terabithia that scarred us all forever, in a good way. Since then, she showed up on Dwayne The Rock Johnson's remake Race to Witch Mountain, did some work for Robot Chicken, and Funny or Die, and most notably, played Carrie Bradshaw in Sex and the City prequel The Carrie Diaries. She also starred in Soul Surfer in 2011. Her most recent significant role came in the 2016 TV historical drama Mercy Street, where she played Alice Green. In 2019, she played Lacey in the crime drama The Act. Next up, we'll see her in an LGBT drama called Freak Show, which is the feature film directorial debut of filmmaker Trudy Styler, aka Mrs. Sting, with the cast including Abigail Breslin, Bette Midler, and Laverne Cox. Oh, and did we mention it's based on a book by Club Kid legend James St. James? Very strange indeed. And that's the end. Thanks for watching. Remember to like, subscribe, and check out our other videos. See ya, guys.